Thanks, Neeraj. That was very, very insightful. And yeah, as you happen to mention, the standardization of documents, that's something that I personally am currently doing for two financial institutions already, because the model doesn't work unless you have standardized documents. So that's a very important point. And so just before your question, so the basic question, Neeraj, I have in this is, how comfortable is SPI with the existing security package, and do you actually meet an FSCR of 1.25 in all your rooftop financings?
So if I'm funding with a debt to equity of 70-30 and been depreciation being done at an CRC level, so generally what we are seeing in the FSCR is being calculated book value, not an actual asset value. So if been depreciation has been done at an CRC level, yes, we have been able to meet our FSCR requirement. The way we have seen this transaction and the way we have understood this program is that we are not looking at it as an asset-backed financing, we are looking at a cash flow-based financing. So for us, when we do an assessment, it's very important to assess who the off-taker is, how strong the PPA has been worded. So it's totally depend upon the risk of an off-taker. As of now, we are not taking an SME risk. SME risk is what we are not comfortable. We are looking at large corporate or a customer base, which is an existing client of SBI, which has been banking with us, and we know that what the company is and what does the future look like. So we are totally relying on a cash flow-based financing, and FSCR is based on a book value.
So this is more of corporate lending as opposed to the strict project lending?
No, it's totally a project finance lending. It's not a corporate lending. Only thing is the cash flow, instead of a discount cash flow, I'm looking at a cash flow from an third party, which is a reputed third party where the PPA has been signed. So if somebody goes and sign a PPA with a AAA entity, I at least have a comfort that AAA entity will keep servicing the PPA tariffs. And in case by any chance they have to wind up, they are strict termination clauses under the PPA, and under the termination clauses, I expect the AAA entity will pay the termination payments and my loan will get settled. So for me, at this moment, it's very important to take care of an off-taker risk, and second thing is the PPA draft, which based on which I am relying.
Okay. Yeah, my question was this, the loan, project loan that you guys are giving, is it also applicable for, like, I'm working with one of our clients who has taken some SECI projects, some allocation they got in the first SECI, and in the second one also they have taken one on RESCO model and one on EPC model, which is there. So for those kind of clients also you are willing to give the thing?
So we are working for all RESCOs. So we've seen that RESCOs, wherever they've been able to get us a good PPAs, we are ready to take, and we are quite comfortable with government risk. So if it's a central government or a ministry risk, we are ready to take the ministry risk PPA. Again, my issue is most, again, on a PPA drafting. We have seen that the draft of SECI, which was there for the 500 megawatt announcement, we were not comfortable with the PPA. The basic clauses of substitution and assignment were not there. Okay. And I believe he'll agree with me that if I'm taking the total cash flow risk, I need a substitution and assignment, right? So we have redrafted those PPAs. We have given back those PPAs to SECI and said, if anything we want to fund under those schemes, we want a PPA, which is what we want. So SECI has agreed that wherever SBI will finance, they'll ask the similar PPAs to be signed. So
okay.
Yeah. So yeah, we are not okay with the SECI PPA. You need to talk to SECI and ask them to give the PPA which we have sent to them. We have done a stakeholders meeting along with the SECI, and we have given our PPA to various stakeholders, and none of the stakeholders had an issue that time on our draft.
Thank you. We will be looking forward to working with you.
Yeah, sure.
Just to sort of detail out Neeraj's point, I think what they are looking for is a direct right of substitution at minimal cost, which can be achieved only if that is embedded in the PPA. Without it being permitted in the PPA, there's no way that the substitution can happen. And other than substitution, the security in a rooftop doesn't sort of make sense. That's one aspect of it. The second aspect, which I don't know whether you sort of insist on, is in any private backed PPA, I would much rather go for an arbitration governed by a foreign body, although it will be conducted within India, as opposed to a court-approved litigation if it comes to that. because institutional arbitration has yielded much faster success as opposed to court litigations, which all of us know can take a decade, if not more. So in addition to the assignment and substitution, if you are sort of going and approaching SECI, it may be worthwhile to also talk about institutional arbitration as opposed to just court proceedings. And this is not only for SECI PPS, but for any PPS that you're doing as rooftop. I think any financier would be more comfortable looking at those arbitration clauses as opposed to court-driven processes for enforcement.
One query here. I think MNRE has come up with this new bidding guidelines for solar, where they talk about this substitution rights plus, you know, payment security mechanism and
That's so for ground mounted solar. It's nothing as of now for
rooftop. So.
Yeah, and within the MNRE, under an MNRE, SECI is an MNRE organization, and the PPS which has come to us has been told to us that it has been approved by Attorney General. Before, without Attorney General, they cannot bring out the PPA. But that was an issue. We have realized that the relevant definitions were there, but the relevant clauses were deleted. So somebody has used the correct PPA, but just removed the relevant lender protection rights from there.
Deleted the right clauses, yeah. And just to add to that, the concept of escrow and payment security, if you go back even historically, has been there in a lot of PPAs. It's just that it has never been implemented because no one sort of gone. But with the recent bidding that has happened, the security structure has been finalized and a payment security mechanism has been established.
So I think indeed very, very energetic, very enlightening presentation and panel discussion by distinguished panelists. Thank you very much. May I request a round of applause for this session.